Once upon a time, in a deep and ancient forest, there lived a pair of crafty goblins.
The crafty goblins did everything together. Until one day, when darkness overwhelmed the big wooden house in which they lived.
Blamed for the darkness, Brother Goblin was forced to leave the forest, while his sister had to stay behind. Though they sought the help of their friends in the forest, they found that no one wanted to delve into the long-gone past.
This is how the goblins found themselves alone in the woods, trying to discover why darkness had submerged the big wooden house.
Tomorrow we should play Compass and North Star in the woods.
Be sure to wear your hat then.
You be sure to wear your hat.
All right, who wants ice cream?
Me!
Eat up.
Ice cream. Without a word, she went out and buried the tiara in the ground beneath the sapling. And as the final scoop of dirt fell, the tiara felt truly gone. And with it, the final link to her old self. She could only go forward and find a new place for herself in this world, where she was no longer truly a princess in a tiara and a beautiful gown, but a wan woman, alone in a deep and ancient wood. And that was how the princess lost her most precious treasure. And her title.
I don't like that story. There were no goblins, and it was depressing.
We won't read it again.
I love you, Mom. Not me. Just kidding. Love you, Mom.
I love you too. Sleep well and dream, my doves.
Ollie? older.
Tell me why Chapter 2 found all these secrets. Oh my. This game looks beautiful, though.
You doing all right? I thought coming here would be closing a chapter of our lives, you know?
And instead, we spun off a whole miserable prequel trilogy. Okay. No. We're not letting ourselves do this again. Come on. Mind-numbing labor's a great way to forget your troubles.
Can't we just have coffee instead?
No. On your feet, soldier. Let's take a break from packing and sort out the furniture. If we get enough done, I'll drive you into town and buy you a gallon of ice cream.
Mint chocolate chip, 2 gallons. Let's do this. Goblin face is keep. Dollar sign is donate or sell. And trash can is, well, trash. By the way, I cleared out most of the stuff from the bathroom this morning, but I left you the toilet.
How very generous of you.
Making a little bit of noise, but I hope you don't mind.
do with this?
Probably sell the decent table.
Maybe someone would be willing to refinish it.
Probably too big to take.
Oh. What's this doing down here? Is that gum? That was probably me.
New collectible, the big frog.
I completely forgot we had a pet vole for a few days.
Poor vole, you know? She was in rough shape when we found her. Did they marry her?
Quite right, love.
She can have my corn.
Here you go, little one. Must be hungry, too.
Tessa really did keep us all fed.
She always tried to take care of everyone. Still does. Yes.
I guess it's finally time to take these pictures down.
Yeah.
Hello.
Still deciding what to do with them.
I mean, most of them are pretty happy memories.
I guess.
You look cute here.
That's not me. I mean, it is, but...
I get it.
But
I get
not
it.
Really. I get it.
It's just weird seeing myself like that again.
Damn.
Didn't think a picture could throw me like this anymore.
Has therapy helped at all?
Oh, yeah, definitely. My therapist really heard me when I said I was a guy, and she helped me get ready for the reactions I get, you know? It's dealing with other people, it's been way harder than figuring myself out. At the end of the day, being able to look in the mirror and see Tyler, that's made the biggest difference, which is why I'm scheduling my top surgery as soon as we sell this house. No more putting a binder on every morning. God, that sounds fucking amazing.
Yeah, totally. Just so you know, I'll be there to help out when you do. Whatever you need.
Thanks.
All right. What's your verdict, Ronan?
You know what? I'll keep a few. To remind us how far we've come.
That's cute.
Oh, man. I love this one.
Why do I look so pissed? I remember loving this.
Maybe because Marianne was sticking a camera in your face?
Come on, honey, smile, like Allison.
Hold up your fish.
It's not my fish anymore. Allison stole it.
The fish thief.
You were just being bratty.
Was I, though?
Yes. All I did was help clean it when we were out on the porch. Eddie had to force you to share. Ugh. Gross stain is gross.
What happened?
Some unfortunate spillage that brought about the end of indoor tea parties. I hid the stain with my toys, forgetting that they would eventually be picked up.
Brilliant.
Well, I seem to recall a time you stole an egg, put it on the couch, and sat on it because you wanted a pet chicken.
We don't talk about that.
Uh-huh.
Well, at least I...
Eddie, now, take your time. He's not gonna jump up and do the cha-cha.
What about me? I wanna clean the fish, too. It's not even...
even your fish. You didn't catch anything.
Ugh, only because you wouldn't stop talking and scared all the fish away.
Keep your eyes on what you're doing. Allison, when we're done with this half, you can take over and do the other one. That sound fair?
Yes.
You're right. I was kind of being brat. Allison, I asked you to clean up the coffee table 3 times already.
Oops. I forgot.
Okay, I'll do it. I'm sorry.
All right. I'll clean it up.
Thanks. While you do that, I'll check out the furniture. I'm guessing you want to keep the coffee table?
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah. Is that okay?
Sure. I'm not really planning on bringing furniture to Denali. And if I need a base in Juno, you'll have all the furniture I need.
How very non-committal of you. All right. I'll keep it.
I really like that armchair.
It'll look sharp next to your tree stump nightstand.
I'll be the most stylish mountain man ever. But I was actually thinking it should go in your library.
Library? We may not even have a living room.
I have faith in you.
Another one for the landfill.
Say it, but the couches get a one-way ticket to the dump.
No protest here. I think I have permanent knee damage from a decade of bumping into the corner of those damn things.
Well, then that's it for the living room. You are relieved from your duties.
I mean, that one looks pretty cool. But they've been sat here for like 10 years, I think. That type of furniture, you can get all sorts in the fabric, probably.
Crummy table and wobbly chairs.
I mean, sell everything you can.
We can make some pretty good money if we sell this. And I know I'd end up eating on the couch most of the time anyway.
I mean, there's no point putting in the trash. Somebody might want it.
Oh, God. What's that smell?
Like delicious garbage.
Ooh,
yes, delicious indeed. Or it could have been Stinky Pants Sam. Oh, Stinky Pants Sam!
Sam, that smell gets the skunk out of our arm. Nice.
A skunk? What did you do to her? Is she okay?
Sure is. She just went hunt for food and couldn't get back out. All she needed was a little nudge to get her on her way.
Sam Kansky, hero of skunk kind.
I remember being super impressed by him, and it made me want to be a wild animal superhero too.
You hungry? We have a whole lot of nothing. We are all out of pickles today. Could I interest you in a ketchup-only sandwich? Looks like there's still a bottle back here.
Ew.
Says the guy who used to eat peanut butter with ranch.
So, hey, Allison, come take a break with me.
Your recipe. If anybody's interested.
Ancient appliances, you are staying here. Although, that oven looks in okay enough shape.
No way. We are not moving here.
fire again?
Yeah, I'm gonna boil some water. You want something to drink?
Coffee, tea.
Coffee, Earl tea. Grey or chai?
Your call. I'm fixing myself a good old cup of joe.
Ah, a nice pot of wakey-wakey juice.
Papa needs his rocket fuel.
I'm so glad Eddie came through on the caffeine.
Shh, did you hear that?
The Ice King is sending us a warning.
Spooky.
For your punishment, said the Ice King, you shall be banished from the forest. Shall feel my anger in your gut. Hear it in the wind. Whoosh!
Huh. Do you think the Ice King would really react that way? He may be intimidating, but he's always fair and never.
Oh, yeah. You're right. Maybe he tells the goblins to help the people they hurt instead?
Great idea, sweetie. Why don't we think about it at dinner? I'll put everything away for safekeeping while you go wash your hands.
Can you put them in the binder so they don't get stained?
I think my dark and twisty version was better.
Put so many hours into that book.
Yeah. The binder was full of extra drawings and incomplete stories. I think they're all still in the kitchen drawer.
We should go take a look. Come check this out. Allison's first drafts. Right. Because I didn't contribute at all.
Come on. I know you did. I can't believe she kept all these.
You'd think putting them on the fridge for a couple of weeks would have been enough.
You know how we thought of ourselves as the goblins? Did you ever get the sense that maybe Marianne was the princess in the stories?
Yeah. She called her bedroom the princess's sanctum, and she was all alone in the woods, in this house, until we showed up.
She was. Alone, but with a few friends who helped her along the way.
What are you doing?
Research. So, if Marianne was the princess, then who were all the rest?
And here we go.
Oh, come on. Humor me.
Oh my god, I can't remember. understood the wolf's need to hunt, but when he saw the princess, he was struck by her beauty, and he knew he had to help. With a great roar, the bear heaved onto his hind legs, rising to his full height. The wolf snapped and snarled in its direction, but the bear roared again, and the wolf took off into the trees, still between his legs. The old bear fell back down onto all fours and stood up at the princess. She regarded him fearfully. "You can come down," he said, just one strip of dried fish. The goblins grabbed it all and gobbled it up, but they were still hungry. They went out into the woods to look for more to eat. First they dropped by the small pond. A big frog was asleep, and beside the pond was a pile of insects she had caught for eating after she woke up. The goblins crept up to the pile, careful not to wake the big frog. As they got close, she repeated loudly and they froze. And gobbled it up, but they were still hungry. As they crept back into the woods, they found the stalwart moose watching them. Did you just steal the big frog's food? The goblins tried not to look guilty but failed. She said we could have them, they cried. Oh really, asked the moose. Let's ask her. So the moose woke up big frog and asked, did you say the goblins could have your food? The big frog looked at the goblins, who she knew were always hungry. Yes, I did. Really? Asked the moose, surprised. Frog nodded, and the moose sighed. All right then, he said, and he had to let the goblins go. Their next stop was the river. They watched as Old Bear swiped at the leaping salmon, catching it deftly in his large paws. He lay it upon a rock and left it to dry, lumbering into the woods to seek out some berries. The crafty goblins crept up to the rock and carefully in case the Old Bear the rocks, grabbed the salmon, gobbled it up, but they were still hungry. As they crept back into the woods, the stalwart moose was once again waiting for them. Are you going to tell me Old Bear said you could have that? Yes, replied the goblins. Old Bear ambled up at the moment Moose asked him, did you leave that fish for the goblins? Old Bear looked at the goblins, who he knew were always hungry, and nodded. I did, he said. Really? Asked the moose. Really, said the Old Bear. After Moose left, Old Bear said to the goblins, be sure to tell the princess I was kind to you, and don't steal my fish again. The goblins, still hungry, went out looking for one more meal. They crept up to the Mangy Muskrat's lodge and began to climb inside, where they were dragged right back out. The moose dangled them by the seats of their pants and said, now I know, Muskrat didn't tell you that you could eat his food because he blames you for his coat being ruined. Besides, he barely has enough for himself and doesn't share with anyone. The goblins began to protest, but he shook his head. He set the goblins down and said, come with me. The goblins followed the moose to a part of the river where it ran slow enough for them to walk into it safely. He gave them each a fishing line and said, I'm going to teach you to fish, so that when you're hungry, you did not need to steal in the forest. It will be hard work, but it will be honest. Crafty goblins were not against hard working hard. They were just hungry, and so they listened to Moose and soon pulled wiggling fish out of the river. They ate them up, and finally they were no longer hungry. And that is how the moose came to teach the crafty goblins to fish. Well, Tessa, the pelican, helped her through the winter, gave them food.
You done?
Pelican.
She was the most generous one.
You go here.
So, pelican is her. Moose told them to fish. That's Sam. Sam's gotta be the bear. Sam really liked her.
The bear was the most helpful one. He was always around.
Stalking her?
What? No.
I mean, he was kinda always there, lurking.
How do I?
Oh, there we go. Alright, I think I'm done.
You sure?
How do you like them apples?
You know, I think you might be onto something. What about these guys? I don't see them being real life people, or this one.
Yep, totally Marianne.
Why a princess?
That's the bomb.
Why not a queen?
She hated authority.
Yeah, she'd have been a terrible ruler.
The specific human attributes you have assigned to these forest animals are truly thought-provoking.
Indubitably.
Oh, spooky. Nothing to say about that one.
You better hurry, or the Mad Hunter will catch us! We need to hide. This way!
Forgot about that. We've been pretending he was there.
And then suddenly he was.
That was the only time that happened, right?
Hello.
Allison. Wait. It felt way too real. It was
us pushing our imagination way too far.
There's someone at the door.
Great. Sam Kansky, Grandmaster of Bad Timing. We're not done with this conversation.
Morning, Sam.
Ahoy, goblins. I ran into Chief Brown, who said you were starting to clean up on the house this morning, so, I kind of figured you might need some supplies.
That's... Thank you. That was very thoughtful.
Oh, also got something for you, Tyler. Every man needs a good knife. There you are.
Thanks, Sam.
Good. After Sam has been educated, he's good with it. He's not confused or anything.
Before I forget,
he's accepted it.
For the lady of the house.
Which is really good to see. Remember the last chapter? He was a bit confused.
It was your mom's favorite recipe. Still make it darn near every week. Thank you for every time.
Thanks.
Cool.
But we don't have a stove. Still no electricity.
Oh, yeah. Fuse box is busted. Just another thing I've been meaning to put back together around here.
Where is it? I can take care of it.
Oh, I don't doubt you can. But, I've been kicking this thing back to life for the last 20-some years. I'll give you a hand.
All right.
Box is in the barn. Follow me.
We'll be right behind you.
Well, I guess old bears can learn new tricks.
Yep. Come on. Let's go get our electricity back on.
So, how's school?
I graduated already. Outdoor studies.
Oh, outdoor studies. Well, it's a good thing I came along when I did. You know what? Built this here barn for your mama.
You really helped her out, huh?
Nah, you know, just a few chores here and there. I was glad to help. Your mother, she... No. I never bring myself to leave her high and dry. Anyways, let me find that door key.
Just open the door.
And give us our keys. all of them.
Well, I figured I might still need to do some maintenance, so...
Nope. We're good. Thank you.
Fair warning. Door's a bit temperamental.
Haven't you been taking care of this place? You didn't oil the doors?
What? You think I just hang out here all day or something? Here, son. Give me a try.
Good.
Okay, when you twist it as far as you can to the left, give it a nice little jerk.
Damn it.
No shit.
The door is open now.
Thanks.
Yeah.
All right.
Oh, God.
Let's go into plugs. Should be easy enough.
Is it?
This one.
Sure.
Yeah, sure.
We got two yellows. What's yellow? That's a 20, okay. 20 is yellow. And that must mean that one is a 30.
Seems good.
Sweet. Color code. Cool.
Oh. You damn fool.
Everything okay?
You two look like you got this all in hand, so,
Oh, Sam.
Bye.
What was that about?
I do want to say that looks...
Sam got so upset.
Oh, he probably forgot he was all that bourbon.
Hey, that's not cool. Sam has a serious problem.
Sorry. He really freaked out when he saw the gun on him. Remind me, Zayn.
It looks tiny, but okay.
Predator. What's that? Ew, what? I sense a story.
Well, by story you mean using it as fireweed to get rid of some rats, and then spilling it on my only pair of shoes. Then yes. Hey, it was not funny.
Sure thing, B-boy.
Hey there, little buddy.
Hey, spiders.
If we end up living together, you should know my house has a no spiders rule.
Well, in my house, we don't kill them.
Ugh. You can take them outside, then.
That's bad.
What are we gonna do with this wreck?
Take it apart and sell the scrap?
Sure.
Be my guest. It sure looks like a pile of junk to me.
Where you see junk, I see dollars. Oh, man. I'm gonna put together the sweetest toolbox ever.
Huh, look at this. I think this is where she made all her toys. She was so crafty.
And she could draw and write.
Toilet paper tubes, rope, cardboard.
Maybe a car? Ooh, or a tank. Allison, do you know who this is?
Should I?
What did you find?
Do you know who that is?
Yeah. That's Carol, Eddie's mom. I've seen other pictures of her, but never this one.
Man, look at Brown. And Marianne. She looks really happy.
Can I?
Careful, the glass is broken.
Are you okay? Stings. Let's go see Mom.
But you'll get mad. You weren't even supposed to be here.
Not the memory.
Come on, it's gonna get infected. She said not to disturb her and Eddie. Where are you going?
Things were different when she was around.
We were family, Eddie. How could you do this to me?
Shh. Look. I had to make that call.
What are they talking about? I can't figure out what's going on.
I don't know. I remember that whatever Eddie had to do, whatever that call was about, it was tearing him up.
Tearing him up? He was being a total cop, and Marianne got pissed and threw him out. Here, I'm gonna show you what I remember. Over here, Allison.
Right here, Tyler. You see what you remember?
I had to make that call. I was just following the law.
Oh, yeah? And this little visit right here? What would the law say about this, huh?
Look, I didn't have to come out here, but I did.
You're a goddamn hypocrite. Get out of here!
Marianne.
I said get out! Out!
Both, probably. What?
She didn't throw the picture at him.
You sure about that? He's being a complete dick.
How can you be sure? We were eavesdropping. We could barely see a thing.
What do you think happened then?
Oh. What do I think?
Look. I had to make that call. I was following procedure. What I'm legally required to do.
Then why are you here? Pretty sure this is a procedure.
I wanted you to hear it from me. Marianne, I'm sorry.
Please just go.
How do we keep remembering the same things so differently?
It was a long time ago, and, well, memory is a tricky thing.
Wait, when did that happen?
I'm not sure. I think it was the exact same day she attacked you.
That's what I thought.
Uncle Eddie said he hadn't seen Marianne for weeks.
Yeah, that was bullshit. And what was all that about following the law? What was he doing here exactly?
I don't know. I have no idea. We shouldn't jump to any conclusions.
Look, I know he took care of you. But that doesn't make him incapable of lying.
I can't see him being that cold with Marianne. Even if he was being a cop.
I mean, I can. But who knows? Guess memory's a tricky thing, huh?
She was clearly on edge that day. And clearly upset. considering how she was at the night time. Maybe. Because if she was calm, and then light broke down, because usually, you know, as humans, if we're gonna panic, we panic there and then we gotta deal with it, rather than calm.
So, we agree. Brown came out here and bullied Marianne the same day she attacked us. And then lied about it. Now what?
Yeah, he lied as well.
Get a straight answer from him.
He also lied to us.
Right now?
Yes. Kind of why I'm thinking
I'll go get my car
for a jerk.
But what would these mountains of trash do without us?
Fuck the trash.